Friends, today we are going to discuss magnetic field at the center of an equilateral triangle. So we have made a diagram of an equilateral triangle in which current I is flowing and a perpendicular line is drawn at the center whose distance is R. So angles of equilateral triangle have been mentioned here, and each side is 2A. Okay, each side is 2A, that is, here this is also 2A, this is also 2A, so this is also full is of 2A, so we have separate the line, we have drawn a perpendicular distance, so it will be A, it will be also A. So according to Baryard-Savart law, for a finite charges, we have formula mu naught I 4 pi r sin phi 1 plus sin phi 2. So in equilateral triangle, three sides are present. So multiply it with 3. 3 mu naught I 4 pi r into, put the value of sin theta, that is 60 degree plus 60 degree. And sin 60 value is equal to root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2. We got this 3 mu naught I 4 pi r into root 3. So 3 mu naught I 4 pi r into root 3. So we are multiplying root 3 by up and root 3 by down. I think there will be no doubt. So we get 3 mu naught I into 3, that is 9 mu naught I upon 4 pi r root 3. So we can find the angle, we can find the value of r by tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base. So perpendicular, that is R, this is perpendicular line R upon base A. So tan 30 is equal to 1 upon root 3 is equal to R by A, and tan 30 value is 1 upon root 3, which is equal to R by A. Then R is equal to A by root 3, and by putting this R value in this equation, we get 9 mu naught I 4 pi A. As you can see, I have done the solution here. So once again, I am repeating, magnetic field at the center of equilateral triangle. We have made an equilateral triangle whose sides, each sides are 2A, and made a perpendicular distance R from the center. So by Baryard-Savart law, for a finite charges, the formula is mu naught I 4 pi upon r sin phi 1 plus sin phi 2. So three sides are present, the 3 into mu naught I 4 pi r in sin 60 plus sin 60, 3 mu naught I 4 pi r into root 3. By solving the equation, we get root 3. So 3 mu naught I upon 4 pi r into root 3, multiplying upper by root 3 upon lower by root 3, is equal to 9 mu naught I upon 4 pi r root 3, and we can find the value of r from tan theta. So tan 30 is equal to r by a, 1 upon root 3 is equal to r by a, r is equal to a by root, r equal to a by root 3. By putting the value of r, we get 9 mu naught I upon 4 pi a. Thank you.